Hey everybody, it's time to get the boat out of its winter slumber and get it ready for the season. And I need to get the truck around here and hook it up and haul it out into the sun so I can see what I'm doing. And I'll get working on that and be right back. Well, we've got it out. Seem to have survived the winter fairly well. And let me get some stuff set up here and we'll continue. All right, the first thing I need to do is I need to remove this hold down strap so that I can get into the engine compartment, because it's right over the top of it and I can't open it with that on there. And so what I use, it's basically got this ratchet mechanism here, and I've got to take the tension off of it so I can flip this thing here over and release the tension. So I do that with this big Allen wrench that I got that's usually in my truck. Oops. I'm trying to do this one-handed. I don't know if I can do it, but we'll see. There we go. Okay. Loose. Now we gotta go unattach it from the other side. Just hooks on this side of the trailer. And I'll wind it back up down on here. Thing to fall on my head, hit me in the head. Okay. There we go. And then when it's done, this just hooks onto there. There, just like that. All right, now I gotta get up in there and get into the engine cover and lift the back up here so that I can install the battery. Because these seats are in the way of tipping the motor cover up, I have to unscrew the hinges down the bottom there so that I can totally remove the engine cover to get that out of the way. And so, with the proper tools, we'll be taking that out. All right, got the engine cover off, just sitting over here on the seat. And now we've got full access to installing the battery. And this is the 3-liter Mercruiser that comes with my boat. This was a original engine to the boat, as far as I know. It was not completely rebuilt, but it was refreshed, I don't know, about 5 years ago. It had the cylinders honed and new rings put in, had a valve job done on it, but they didn't completely tear it down and put like new bearings and all that stuff. So it wasn't a full rebuild, but it was a refresh. So it's you know, in fairly new condition now. Of course, since it was winterized, it's been fogged with oil and stuff, so it's going to be a little rough running when it first starts up. Hopefully it will start up. I've had my battery for this boat on a trickle charge all winter, so it should be ready to go. And it sits right over in there, and I'm going to go grab the battery and put it in, and I will be right back.
All right, we got the battery installed. I had to put that bag over the top of the battery because the boat place that I take it to for winterization wrote my name across the top of the battery, so yeah, got to cover that up. But otherwise, everything seems to be going. I did try hitting the turning on the blower switch, which is right here. Even though the blower sounds a bit crunchy, it works, so we've got power. Now the next thing I have to do is actually I need to lower the outdrive, because the outdrive is in the up position. I want to go all the way down, and I can't really tell where it's at. You can kind of see it out there. I think that's good. All right, let me get out of the boat here for a moment. Come around and check, and it's good. The only thing I got to do is I got to peel this tape off the propeller, because this is where the exhaust comes out, and since they didn't wrap it the whole boat, they covered this up so no water would get in there and split anything over the winter. Getting there. There. Should be all set. A little bit of paint chipping off, but that's okay. All right, now I need to get my earmuffs on there so we can have water to the engine, and then we're pretty much ready to give it a start. All right, we got the earmuffs on with the garden hose hooked up. The water's not turned on yet, but see, you just need to slide it on over these intake ports on the side. Make sure it's sitting down. It's going to leak like crazy when you turn the water on, because more water is going to come through than the engine will take, especially when it's not even running yet. And make sure that one's good. That one's good on that side. That just keeps the water from going through and out the other side, forces it to the pump to actually grab it and pull it up into the engine. And I just need to turn the water on, and now we'll be ready to see if she'll start up. Be right back. Okay, we're ready to give it a shot here now. I'm gonna give it a few pumps. I can actually hear the carb squirting some gas. I don't know how much is in there, because I may need to crank it to build up some fuel pressure, but we'll see how it goes. Almost. Thank you. started up pretty good. I mean, it took a little bit of cranking probably to get the holes filled up in the carburetor. But it's running good. Let's see what's going on out here. Got the engine cam set up. It's running. I see water coming out where it's supposed to be. Should be good. Just take a peek in here, make sure I don't see any leaks anywhere. De-winterization and first startup of my 1986 Four Winds 170 Horizon, and the first start of the 3-liter Mercruiser for the 2023 summer season. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye now. I did shut that off on purpose. Thank you. Bye.